Hello, I'm Andrea, and I've got another video for you. I've installed a Debian bookworm, Debian 12 bookworm, on two of my computers. One has got Debian bookworm with the Mate desktop, and the other has got Debian 12 bookworm with the Cinnamon desktop. And they're running so well, I thought that on this computer I've got, this laptop, I would install Debian this time with the Gnome desktop environment. And here it is, as you can see, this is the Gnome desktop environment. And it's slightly different to that of Ubuntu Gnome. Ubuntu uses Gnome desktop environment also, and the Gnome desktop environment I've got on my other computer from Linux Mint is the Ubuntu desktop, but this is pure Gnome desktop. I mean, there is a package called Vanilla Gnome Desktop in Ubuntu, so I don't know if Debian uses Vanilla Gnome Desktop or not. And there's two ways which you can install the Gnome desktop environment on Debian. I first started off with a net install, and I installed Gnome Flashback as my main desktop, which is going to get installed anyway when you install Gnome with its Gnome shell extensions. And I installed GNOME Core, sudo apt install GNOME Core, because if you install the GNOME desktop environment, it pulls in the whole of the desktop, the whole of it. And GNOME comes with a massive amount of applications, six media players, and apps that you're never going to use. Whereas if you install GNOME Core, you get the main components required to run the GNOME desktop environment. And then you can install what media players and software you want yourself. It does come with some software with media players and text editors, which you can't remove because it's part of the GNOME desktop, but it's only very minimal because with GNOME you get LibreOffice, which is, tied in with the desktop. And I don't like LibreOffice, I just like to install my own text editors. I don't need an office suite. Anyway, this isn't a GNOME menu. I'll just close this now. You click on activities and you click this, and this is the start screen. Well, the GNOME menu, it's not the start screen. That's Windows 8 that has a start screen. This doesn't. You can search for things here. Oh, I didn't ask for time shift. Why is it giving me that? This is the text editor that comes bundled with it, which is GNOME text editor, and it's got different customization options. Here you can change the backgrounds, which is nice. I mean, it's good for viewing text files, but for doing copying and paste, I prefer gedit, which I've also have, which is this. And to get to your start menu, you press the Windows key or the super key, depending on your computer, and you've got your pinned favorite applications here. Yeah. Just get something to drink, some water. And these are all your applications which launch from here. And this is Time Shift. I've installed Time Shift so that if anything goes wrong with my system, it's like the Windows System Restore for Linux. Time Shift is the Linux version of System Restore, and I've installed this so if anything goes wrong, I've created a restore point. I can restore my computer if anything goes wrong with my system, which is not going to happen, I don't think. Not very often anyway with Linux. This is GNOME software. I think you've seen it before, so I'm just going to show you the customization options today because the software I've got in here is very much the same as what I've got on my other computers. I don't really change. This is the software I've got. But this is the GNOME Software Center, which shows the software that's installed and other software that they recommend and that can be installed. And there's another applications menu here because it comes with GNOME extensions, GNOME Core, and it came with the applications menu and places. And oh, when I am I can minimize windows. When I minimize the minimize windows appear here in this bottom panel. And I'm running Debian Bookworm. Debian Bookworm 12 with the GNOME desktop, and Debian is using a later version of GNOME, which is GNOME 43, because Ubuntu uses GNOME 42 and it's using a later kernel. Debian uses kernel 6. Ubuntu and Linux Mint are still using kernel 5 or something, I don't know, but they're using kernel 6.1 on Debian, so Debian's using a later kernel. But Linux Mint and Ubuntu are still using kernel 5, and Ubuntu uses GNOME 42, and so does the Linux Mint use GNOME 42 if you install the desktop environment from Linux Mint, as I have. But Debian is installing GNOME 43, which is a later version of GNOME. So this is the later version of GNOME, and it's slightly different from GNOME 42. You've got your applications here. And this is where you can toggle with dark and light mode for themes, and the Wi-Fi is displayed here. You can get to the GNOME Control Center from here. And here's the dark theme for anyone that's interested, which I don't like very much, so turn it back to light theme again. And all the networks are working, look. So all my wireless networks are working. As you can see, they're all broadcasting, which is good. I can view them from here and connect to the one that's mine or others if I've got any other networks. So all the settings are here. GNOME 43. As well as this menu here, which I've shown you, I have got this here, which is the applications menu, so I can launch applications from here. And this is the GNOME image viewer. I prefer Gwen view, but this is good. You can also use this to set your desktop wallpaper, which I'll show you a bit later on. And I've got the usual applications that I normally have on here, the same as what I've got on my other computers. Well, I think you know what they are if you've seen my other videos. I've got the KDE applications and the Office apps, K-Organizer. This is what I normally have. Here it is, K-Organizer. I didn't click it properly, I don't think. I've also got the screen recorder on, so it slows things down a bit. I'm using Kazan this time. It seems to be working. The one drawback is that with Debian is it comes with, you get Firefox ESR, which I don't like. I don't like Firefox ESR. It is a very old version of Firefox ESR. But you can... which is not the latest version of Firefox. There's two versions of Firefox, Firefox ESR and Firefox. But you can install the latest version of Firefox, and I've got WaterFox on here, which I've installed myself. I've also got Chromium browser. This is how you view the minimized windows here. They appear in this taskbar here. You close it. So this is pretty much what vanilla GNOME looks like, but you still get quite a lot of tools, and you can easily access your menu by clicking this. I've got Open Shop Video Editor, which is this. Ah, here it is. This is the latest version, because Debian has a very older version of OpenShot, and so does Ubuntu, so I've installed this as an app image, which from the web I just downloaded the file and just ran it, and there it is. This is places to get to your home folder. I'm running Nemo as my default file manager, but it also has Nautilus. And one thing, you know, the reason why I use Nemo over Nautilus is because it is a better file manager. And I'm just going to show you the extensions I've got. I'll show you something else, because Ubuntu comes with a dock. It comes with a dock. And I've also installed this myself, but all the extensions came with the GNOME desktop in Debian. The only extensions I had to install was the Arc menu, dash to dock, and dash to panel. So I've only had to install three extensions. I installed dash to dock because I think Ubuntu either uses its own customized dock or dash to dock. I'm not sure, but here it is. So this is like, if you're a new user to GNOME, the dock is actually very helpful. And now I can launch my applications from the dock. There's GNOME Weather. And if I want to pin something to the dock, I just click pin to dash. And there it is. And it's the same as the Ubuntu. It's very similar. I think this is what the one that Ubuntu uses, because look, I've minimized the weather, and when it's minimized, it shows what applications are running. See the white dot there? So I can access everything from here, all my favorite applications, including the software center. It's minimized, so it's running. If I want to close it, just do this. Got GNOME Tweaks, which is this. And what I'm going to do is change a theme. So I've installed the Zorin themes. I want to show you how they look on here. This is how it looks, the Zorin theme. One of the many themes that I've installed. And look. See, it's changed, look. Because this is a light theme, you see, but the menu is also light now. And these are the icons for the Zorin theme, look. I'm going to change it back again. with tweaks. I'm going to use a different theme this time. I've installed all the Linux Mint themes here, but well, these are all the themes I've got. I'm going to install Mint Y. Why not this one? Yeah. So the theme has changed, and I can also change the mouse pointers in here. And all the sounds are working. You can change the fonts and this is GNOME Tweaks. So the theme has changed. Because Debian doesn't come with a lot of themes. I mean, some of the there are some themes that you can install from the package manager, but I like the Mint themes and the Zorin themes, and those are installed myself. But they've got some other themes as well on Debian. And the only thing is that, you know, on Ubuntu and the Linux Mint version, on Ubuntu GNOME, you can add, there is the option, you know, I mean, there's a startup sound setting called, you know, there's a startup sound manager, which they've removed in maybe they've removed it in GNOME 43. I'm not sure, because on Ubuntu there's a startup manager where you can control what applications run at startup, but they seem to have removed it from Debian GNOME, and it's called GNOME system properties. And so now you have, if you want to, I mean, you can, it's still, there's still a startup settings in the hidden folders in your file system, but if you want to add a startup sound here on Debian, you've got to do it manually. To do that, you have to enable view hidden folders, tick this, view hidden folders. Go to home, then go to config, go to auto start. And this is the file I've got here. This is how it looks with the, this is the GNOME text editor. You see, it's a nice text editor, but useless at copying and pasting. But anyway, I'm going to show you it works. Look, it's an executable file. You just run it. My startup sound, and I've set Nemo as my default file manager. I did that by using deconfiguration editor, and so every time I log in, Nemo, the file manager, launches at startup. It auto starts and it draws the desktop icons. I'll show you the code that's in it. This is the startup file. And normally in startup settings on Ubuntu, you just type the command Nemo desktop. But GNOME 43 or Debian GNOME 43 doesn't have startup sound settings. They removed that option, to choose which applications launch at startup. I don't know why, but there you are. But so you have to do it manually. But I don't want to enable hidden files and folders now, so I just untick that, and there's my theme. Here's my icons. And I'm just going to turn these off because I want to show you why else why I use Nemo as my default file manager. You can't uninstall Nautilus because otherwise it will take the whole GNOME desktop with it. See, Nemo displays the computer icon on the desktop, the home folder on the desktop, network and rubbish bin on the desktop, but Nautilus see, I've turned the icons for Nemo off, but if I launch extension, if I go to extensions, scroll down to desktop icons, this turns on Nautilus desktop icons. And now this is Nautilus file manager that's drawing the desktop icons. I mean, Nemo's still my default file manager, so when I click on this, it launches Nemo. But now Nautilus is drawing the desktop icons. But you can see with Nautilus, it'll only show the home folder and the waste paper basket. It doesn't show you the computer or the network icons on the desktop. But you do have various settings with Nautilus. You see, this is the Nautilus settings, and it's got desktop icon settings. You can put the icons here. I don't know why you'd want to have them there, but put them on the right. So you have got various settings, and you can have dark text or light text, but I prefer Nemo because I'm more used to Nemo, but I just think it's a better file manager. It's got more options. So I'm going back to extensions. What I'm going to do is turn this off and turn Nemo on again. So this is Nemo now, and the reason why I use Nemo over Nautilus, there's another reason. It is because with Nemo, I can view my program files in the User Share Applications folder. And this shows all the programs I've got. And I can launch my programs from here, from Nemo, like this. And if I want to put this icon on the desktop, which is Chrome, I just paste it, and I now have a shortcut on my desktop. I can launch it. But with Nautilus, well, I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to view my applications in here, or my see with Nautilus, it doesn't display the applications, it just displays them like this, and it's very difficult to see what you've got on the system. If I want to launch it, I can't, but I can still see with Nemo, I can see all the applications I've got on my desktop, but in Nautilus, when I look at my applications, they just display like this, and I can't run them from here. It doesn't run, but however, I think it's a security thing because Nautilus blocks that, because maybe they don't want users to change any of the applications, but I've tried opening it as root, and it's the same thing, so it's a Nautilus thing, but I'm going to paste it here. And Another thing I don't like about Nautilus is that it's got the toolbar at the side, but I like the toolbar at the top. But with Nautilus, you've got the toolbar at the side. I mean, that's not bad in itself. I can get used to that, but I just don't think it has as good a function as what Nemo has. So that's why Nemo's the default and not Nautilus. But you can't uninstall Nautilus because it's part of the operating system. But so you see, they launch from the desktop. And I'm going to show you something else now. I've installed the Arc menu, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off the dock because I don't need that now. I'm going to turn off the applications menu because I don't need that with the Arc menu. And also, I'll turn off the window list because I don't need the bottom panel either, because enable dash to dock. No. Sorry. Enable dash to panel. I could use the dock, but I don't think it's compatible. I think you have to disable the dock if you're using dash to panel, so I won't enable that while I'm using the Arc menu, but this is it. See, now all my applications are here at the bottom here, and the calendar, which shows the GNOME weather and the GNOME clocks because I've got it installed. And this is the Arc menu. Look, I can launch my applications from here. And this is dash to panel, and it's got various customization settings as well. And the Arc menu, you can also change the start button. It's got various icons in the Arc menu. I'll show you briefly the Arc menu settings. You've got different menu layouts here. I like the mint menu, but there's different menus that you can have here. So it's the same as what it was in Ubuntu, except it works on Debian as well. And dash to panel's got various settings, and you've got various shortcuts here. You can access GNOME System Monitor from here. It's a bit like Task Manager on Windows that you can access from your taskbar. And this is Deconfiguration Editor. I've used Deconfiguration Editor to enable system sounds in GNOME. So I've used Deconfiguration Editor to enable the system sounds here on the GNOME desktop. I also use it on Mate, and I've talked about this in my other video on which is a Debian 12 Mate desktop. So this is Deconfiguration Editor, which I use to enable system sounds, and various other customizations you can enable with this. This is GNOME Terminal. I've also enabled the menu bar, because otherwise when you start it up, it normally starts up like this without the menu bar, but I've enabled the menu bar with a Deconfiguration Editor, which means I don't have to keep enable it when it starts up. It's already automatically enabled. And the system sounds are working. That's because I don't have a file sharing on here. I don't install it, but that's the error sound. So yeah, this is Debian Bookworm with the GNOME desktop environment, GNOME 43. And this is just one of the many customization options you can do on here. So you can customize the GNOME desktop on Debian and install what software you want as well. This is what I'm running, this, as you can see here. And this is the Arc menu. And all your shortcuts are on here as well. I've also got Synaptic Package Manager, and also where you can also edit the repositories from the Synaptic Package Manager, which is also on here. Synaptic. As well as GNOME software. Can edit the repositories. Well, it shows you the software sources, and I've enabled the non-free repositories as well, so I can get non-free drivers and firmware. All the drivers are working, by the way. These are my shortcuts on here. So all the Wi-Fi networks are working. These are all the networks that are broadcasting, including my own. And any other networks that I have, I could connect to. But these are the Wi-Fi networks and the GNOME Control Center. Also change the desktop background. From here. And I'm not really keen on the GNOME image viewer, but I'll show you one other useful feature it has, which GwenView is good, but I prefer it. But this is a backgrounds here. Look, I mean, this is GwenView here that I've installed, which is a KDE app. And this is the GNOME image viewer, which is this, which comes with the GNOME desktop. I have GNOME. And I'm going to open this image now, because one handy feature it has is that if I click on this, I can set it as my wallpaper look. And now the background has changed. So I can also change backgrounds from here. Got more backgrounds here. So a lot of these are the mint background, which is very nice. Yeah. So I've got the mint background and some GNOME background as well, which came with the desktop. So this is Debian 12 Bookworm with the GNOME desktop environment. And it's got lots of customization options. I've still got this menu if I want it, although I could disable this, but I like this as well, because this is also handy. I like the search here. It's, you know, and all the apps run on here, same as they did on Ubuntu. And this is the Arc menu with dash to panel, which gives you the Windows style taskbar and start menu, or should I say, the Cinnamon or Mate taskbar and start menu that you get on Mint. And all of the shortcuts are here. Here's the terminal again. So I'm Andrea, and I hope you've enjoyed watching, and see you on the next time. This is Debian 12 Bookworm with Gnome Desktop, which I'm very happy with, and well, I'll be keeping this desktop on here, and well, I'm very happy with it. It's actually lighter than Ubuntu, but there you are. But Debian is a lighter desktop, but because I think a lot of the software you install yourself, although it comes with software as well, but you can choose a minimal desktop, which is GNOME Core, or GNOME, which gives you the full desktop. I chose GNOME Core, and this is what I got, and I installed a lot of the software myself, not all of it, but most of it, you know, and I think I've showed you the media player, didn't I, that it came with Totem. This is Totem, the media player that comes with the GNOME desktop. It's part of the GNOME desktop, so I can't uninstall it, but I prefer VLC. But anyway, I hope you've enjoyed watching, and yeah, you can customize GNOME quite a lot, actually, more than what most people realize, but I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'm Andrea, and see you again next time in the next video. Until then, bye for now.